morning boys, welcome back to our favorite place, that's our biology lab, wherein all your curiosities, queries can be answered by yourself. When we are dealing with the theory, you get naturally lot of questions. How? Why? So those questions can be answered here in this place. That's why I keep on telling you our biology lab is our favorite place. And in this place, we have been doing experiments and conducting various activities, and we are solving many problems that arise in our mind. And we are able to understand better the theory part of it, which we have studied. As part of it, today we are doing experiment number 6, that is 23rd January 2021. We are doing experiment number 6, and this is meant for class 12 students. And as I have been telling you, for every experiment there will be subheadings, and the subheadings are A, first one A, second materials required, third preparations of course, that comes under materials required, third procedure, and procedure I said you should write in the past tense and point wise as I have written, observations you can write point wise as well as tabulate your observations. Based on your observations, result or conclusion. Again, it should be one or two sentences. And what are the precautions that we need to take when we are performing this experiment? Sketch and label on the unruled page. In your biology record, there are two pages, ruled page and unruled page. On ruled page, you write all the writing work. In the unruled page, draw diagrams, sketch and label neatly. And I told you when you are labeling should be, arrow mark should be towards the path, not towards the name, towards the path, arrow mark to it. And label on one side, preferably. And then, when we are drawing the diagram, take care that it should be scientific diagram. Okay? And then, already I told you when you are drawing the diagram, it should be scientific, it should be proportionate, it should have axis. And of course, being biology boys, time and again, and tell, must draw most beautiful diagrams. Coming back for today's experiment, the heading you can write for today's experiment as salivary amylase activity or activity of salivary amylase. That should be the heading. And what is aim? To study the effect of different temperatures on the activity of salivary amylase on starch. This is the aim of today's experiment. At different temperatures, one we take hot temperature, second we take room temperature, third we take cold temperature. So at these varieties of temperatures, what is the action of salivary amylase? What is salivary amylase? It's an enzyme present in our saliva. And what is enzyme basically? It is a proteinaceous substance. Protein and enzyme are not much difference. So it basically an enzyme is a proteinaceous substance. And remember, recollect your 11th class enzyme chapters, biomolecules, where we talk the factors that affect enzyme activity. In that, first we talked about temperature. Temperature affects enzyme activity. At high temperatures, the enzyme gets deactivated. At low temperatures, enzyme gets denatured. So if enzyme has to work, it has to be optimal temperature. Optimal temperature is normally our body temperature, or when we are performing an experiment like this, room temperature. So normally we consider it as 37 degrees plus or minus 2 degrees centigrade. So that should be the aim. And second, materials required. To perform this experiment, what are all the materials that are required? As you are able to see, test tubes. We have taken test tube stand, as you have seen, test tube holders, beakers, and flask, measuring cylinder, cotton, and of course, we have taken a lot of chemicals along with that. This is called cavity black. So we use cavity black also for this experiment. And what are the chemicals we require for any experiment? When we are performing, we need to prepare some solutions beforehand. A Today we are preparing, giving a demo of the experiment. Yesterday we prepared all the solutions. What are the solutions? 1% starts to solution, 1% NaCl solution, and of course saliva in the ratio of 1:2. What is the theoretical background? Theoretical background, all of us know, plants prepare starch, and the starch is white in color, as you are seeing. Okay, white solution. There is a starch solution. So to this, what we are doing, we are adding ingredients, sodium chloride, and I think already I mentioned 1% NaCl solution, and saliva that we have collected and dilute it to 1:20, and then iodine solution. Iodine solution here it is. So iodine solution, we have got, add to this. What happens? Here, because of iodine, the color will be brown color. Like we are seeing it here, brown color, iodine. So, starch plus NaCl solution, saliva solution, iodine solution. When you add, you get starch iodine. First, you will see blue black color. Like here, you can see blue black color. Okay? And that blue black color is because salivary enzyme present in saliva reacts with the starch with the iodine. So starch plus iodine, the chemical product that is formed is starch iodine. Starch iodine is blue black in color, blue black in color. Hence we are able to see that. Now, what is the procedure that we need to follow? First, 3 test tubes you have to take. And in each test tube, 1 ml iodine solution. Give it support. This is the first one. Second one, 3 experimental test tubes having 5 ml of 1% starch plus 1 ml of 1% NaCl are taken and kept in water baths having different temperatures. Here we go. Here we are saying here, see here, this is one bath and we have kept 2 test tubes, one experimental one, one control one. This is hot water bath. We have boiled water and kept it. This is one. And second, this is normal room temperature. In this normal water we have taken. And test tubes we have taken. In that one is control, one is experimental. Next, third, this is chilled. We have taken cold water, we have kept ice there. Again, in this bath, we have taken 2 test tubes. One is control, another is experimental. So, 3 experimental test tubes having 5 ml of, in fact we have taken 3 plus 3, 6, 1 experimental and 1 control also we have taken. And they are kept at different temperatures, like one we have kept with ice, that is 2 to 5 degrees centigrade, and then one at normal temperature, 37 degrees centigrade, room temperature, another boiled water we have taken, with the help of Bunsen burner we have boiled the water, and it is 70 degrees plus or minus 2 degrees. Okay. Next, 1 ml of diluted enzyme is added to all the 3 experimental test tubes. We have added 1 ml of diluted enzyme. And how much diluted? 1:20 dilution. With the help of a dropper, 1 or 2 drops are taken from the experimental test tube. Okay. And added to the test tube having iodine solution. So this 1 or 2 drops we have taken, we have added to iodine solution. And this is the salivary enzyme, saliva in 1:20 dilution. And in the test tube 2, you can see change of color, that is, this is hot water. Already you can see the formation of blue-black color. So, third one, this is cold water, here also you can see the formation of blue-black, and this one there is no change of color. This is normal temperature, 37 degrees room temperature, and already acronic point means end point is reached. Now this, to reach that acronic point, we need to follow certain procedure. What is the procedure? like with the help of a dropper, 1 to 2 drops are taken from the experimental test tubes and added to the test tube having iodine solution. Now, the time of adding is considered as 0 I. So, this you have to put in the observation table, 0 I. And then this 1 or 2 drops are added at an interval of 2 minutes to the test tube continuing iodine solution. This is repeated until there is no change in the color of the iodine. This is what we have done. At the room temperature, you can see, until there is no change in the iodine color, we kept on adding. And roughly, we have taken 24 to 30 minutes. So, after 24 to 30 minutes, there won't be any change in the color of the iodine. This indicates that we have reached an atomic point. What is the atomic point? Atomic point is the end point. So, same thing we are writing. 1 to 2 drops are added at an interval of 2 minutes. So, we started with the 0 value. No change in color. 2 minutes, 4 minutes, 6 minutes, 8 minutes. Same thing, we can keep it here also in the cavity block. We can add, you can see 4, 3, 12 cavities are there. We can put, keep on adding this enzyme, 1 or 2 drops. First, we start with 0 in the first bit. Second, leave 2 minutes gap, put 1 or 2 drops of enzyme, leave it. After 2 minutes, that is 4th minute, 6th minute, 8th minute, 12th minute, 14th minute, like that. So almost 12 bits, 24 minutes. So after 24 minutes, normally if the color is not changed and the color remains iodine color, like I have shown you, then that means that is the apical point. So timings are recorded by different experimental tubes. We have worked with 3 tubes now. One is at cold temperature, one is at hot temperature, one is normal room temperature, then the atomic points will be reached. And what do you expect out of this experiment? Since at room temperature, enzyme is active, the starch gets digested fast. So that means around 24 to 30 minutes, the starch gets digested because of the salivary amylase. Whereas in the hot carbon test tube, it takes a lot of time to reach the atomic point because at higher temperatures, enzyme gets deactivated. Similarly, third test tube will be taken low temperature where we are taking cold water bath. In the cold water bath, the temperature again, atomic point takes a lot of time because at low temperatures, enzymes get denatured, salivary amylase gets denatured. So when the salivary amylase present in the saliva gets denatured, the starch cannot be digested. It takes a lot of time. Of course, when we are preparing this saliva, dilute saliva solution, we are taking this measuring cylinder, and in this we are also using cotton. We spread the cotton, and then through the cotton spread, we filter the saliva and dilute the saliva in 1:20 ratio. That is the purpose why we are taking this measuring cylinder as well as. Next, observations, put that in the table, in the form of table, for 3 different temperatures you have to put. One for cold, that is 5 degrees plus or minus 2 degrees. Another is room temperature, 37 degrees centigrade. Third one is hot water, that is 70 degrees plus or minus 2 degrees. So you have 3 tables and 3 times at the one point. Normally, we take our room temperature at one point because your experiment will be over within designated 40 minutes. Others, just for our curiosity, we can keep it and find out what is the possible time that is taken. Next, result and conclusion, that is, what is your aim? That should be your result. The effect of different temperatures on the activity of salivary amylase on starch is performed and the timings are atomic point time is noted. So the atomic point timing for all the 3 you can note down. And that shows that at room temperature, enzymes blood glucose. What are the precautions? Since you are operating a lot of glass apparatus, take care, you should not break it. That's one. Second, you are boiling water, you are using the gas Bunsen burner, take care while boiling the water. And third, when you are diluting cellular, ensure that it is 1:20. And you are adding varieties of chemicals, take care that these chemicals do not drop or spit on your skin, so there is likelihood of reaction. Hence, these are the precautions you should take. And most important precaution that you should take is maintain the gap of 2 minutes. You start up first when you add 2 ml of MM solution. You start at the timing at 0. After 0, you have to maintain 2 minutes, then 2 minutes, then 2 minutes. So the gap should be maintained. That is a must. Just add once and go out of the lab and do after half an hour, you come and add second one, your result will be wrong. That should be the precaution. And of course, sketch and label, draw 3 diagrams at least basically. See, these 2 test tubes, experimental one and control one in hot water, experimental one and control one in normal temperature, room temperature, experimental one and control test tubes at ice cold, low temperatures. These 3 diagrams plus the test tube with the timing where you are reaching that atomic point. I expect this also to draw. And if you are drawing cavity black, this one, then you must show in the cavity black the change of colors. Keep on noting it, timings also in note, and then draw that. So this is how you need to perform this experiment. In our next class, we will come with another experiment. Until then, keep practicing. Thank you.